Grace and peace to you from God our Father and our Lord and Savior Jesus the Christ. Amen. You know, I'd like to think that I have a few skills in my repertoire as a human being. I can talk really loud. I can read really fast. I can eat copious amounts of bacon and barbecue ribs. I'm not sure that I have any skills past that. That might be it. But I know one thing that I'm terrible at, and that has anything to do with tools. I mean, if I pound a nail with a hammer in straight, I have accomplished a lot that day. So when something goes wrong in the house, when something breaks, thank goodness that we have a property management committee. And we have plumbers and electricians and carpenters in the congregation, or I call upon my father-in-law, who can fix almost anything if you give him enough time. And my wife does remind me that that is my biggest weakness, that she wishes that I could fix things like her dad. I just don't have that skill. So when something breaks, I call and ask for help. You know, asking for help is sometimes hard for us as individuals because we're prideful people. And we often don't want to ask for help because we think we should do it ourselves. Or maybe we don't want to bother someone else. Or maybe we're embarrassed that we need help at all. But we all need help in life at some point or another. And we have the best helper there is in God. We hear in Psalm 121, I lift my eyes to the hills, from where does my help come? My help comes from the Lord, creator of heaven and earth. We have a God who is willing to help us, to be there for us, who has promised to be there for us in the waters of baptism, that as long as we live this in this life and on this world, we can turn to Him for help. And He even gives us tools for helping. He gives us Scripture, the Bible, a wonderful book to turn to for help in those times of desperation, for help in those times when we begin to doubt our faith, for help in those times when we wonder if God is really present in our life, or when we forget what God has done through the death and resurrection of Jesus Christ, saving us from our sins and giving us eternal life. But God has also given us the tool of prayer. And maybe that's where we often fall short, where we know that we need help, and so we don't go and ask God for it. I think sometimes maybe we're embarrassed by our prayers. Maybe we think our prayer isn't really that important. That God has, I've heard this a lot, God has more important things to worry about. You know who God worries about? You. He's created you. He's sustained you. He's watched you walk through life. He worries about you, and He wants to hear about your life. The good and the bad, the mundane and the extraordinary. He wants to hear from you, but sometimes what happens is when we turn to God for help in prayer, it seems like our prayers aren't answered. It seems like we're praying and praying and praying and nothing's heard. It's kind of like our parable that Jesus tells of the persistent widow. Well, the widow goes to an unjust judge and just complains and nags and bothers until she gets what she wants. Also experienced by all parents with children under 10, or under 20, or under 30, or husbands to spouses, or, you know, all sorts of things. The nagging method often works. That's how I got a Chicago Bear, Walter Payton jersey, by the way. Years of nagging. Years of nagging. But you know, God's not like the unjust judge. It's not like we wear God down with our prayers. No, God grants to us what we need in that moment of prayer. And so often, maybe what we're looking for is different than what God thinks we need. Or maybe God is giving us something completely different. The point of the parable is to remember to keep praying, to be persistent in your faith and trust that God is going to grant you justice and that God is going to be there as He has promised to be through His Son, Jesus Christ. But not only must we turn to God for help, but we turn to each other, don't we? We lean upon each other for help and support in those difficult times, to give us strength where maybe we have none, being bolstered together by the body of Christ. And not only do we always look for help, but we can be help to others. And that's the other point of this parable, is that we are to be proclaimers of justice in the world. That when we see injustice happening, we are to be the advocate for the least, the little, and the lost of the world, to be help for someone else. To reach out our hand to the poor and needy. To reach out our hearts in love and forgiveness. And to welcome all into the embrace of God as we've been embraced by the love and grace of Jesus Christ. My brothers and sisters in Christ, this day I want you to remember that God has given you tools that you can turn to and help. Turn to His Word to hear again the promises of Jesus Christ in you. Turn to Him and prayer and communicate all your desires, all your wants, all your worries and doubts, that He may answer them and give you peace. And may you be a help to others, living out your faith in service to those who need it most. But most especially, remember that you belong to God. In the waters of baptism, you have been made His child. He is there for you always. And when you turn to Him for help, He will be there to answer the call. For that, we can say, thanks be to God. Amen. I ask you, please.